Creating hood zip-up jacket with pad system. Hi, I'm Jin. Welcome to Pattern Studio 101. This channel is all about pattern making. Let's do grading with pad system. I'm going to use the pattern we drafted in episode 123. And we'll show you how to set up grading sizes and enter the grading value for each point. I have a pad hotkey list on my website. Head over to patternstudio101.com and download it. Using hotkeys when you work will save a ton of your time. Okay, let's do the grading. This is the hood zip-up jacket pattern we drafted. To do grading, you need to decide size break. Let's say the pattern we drafted is size medium, and I want to create size extra small, small, large, and extra large. Go to menu, grade, working sizes. The pattern we drafted is base size. I want to say it's medium. And click insert. This will be small. And click insert, extra small. Select the base size. And this time, click add. We're gonna name this large. And click add, extra large. Because I'm going to use one same grading rule, I want to have the same break name. I'm going to change this group name to large. It doesn't matter if it's small, large, I want to have one same name because I'm going to have one same grading rule for all the sizes. And click OK. Okay, let's start with the front. I'm going to do 2 inches grading on the chest. Basically chest, waist, and hem. Same, 2 inches of grading. So when I do 2 inches grading, select the center front neck, go to menu, grade, grading info. I'm going to use this shortcut next time. So grading info, remember my break group is large. I'm going to enter the information here on large. So for this center front, I want to move 1/8 of an inch on plus X axis, and I'm not going to move in Y axis. If you click OK, the point is graded. Okay, select high shoulder point, Ctrl J. So for the high shoulder point, I'm going to go up 1/4 of an inch on X axis, and for the neck width, 1/8 of an inch on Y axis. Then my neck width from high shoulder point to the other high shoulder point will be growing by 1/4 of an inch. Select the neckline. Select the tool, Smooth Path Grading. Click one of the endpoints. I'm going to make this grading smooth. You have 3 options. The first one, progressive from end to end, is mostly okay, but this is very curved line, so I want to try the second one, smooth, keeping the end path angle. Yeah, nothing changed. Okay. Select the shoulder point, Ctrl J. For the shoulder point, 1/4 of an inch on X axis and 1/4 of an inch on Y axis. Click OK. You can grade this point if you have a grading rule for this cross chest. But I'm not going to grade this point. Let's go to the underarm point. Ctrl J. For this underarm point, I'm not going to grade on X axis. I'm going to grade on Y axis. Because my grading rule is 2 inches, I'm going to go up 1/2 of an inch. Click OK. Then select the armhole line. With smooth path grading tool, click the point, and I will keep this second option, and click OK. Select the point at the hem. For this point at the hem, I'm going to have exactly the same grading with this underarm point. So select the tool, copy paste grading. Select the point you want to copy. Then I'm going to copy X and Y both. Click OK. And click the point you want to paste. Then the grading rule is pasted. Okay, for the pocket, if you want to keep the pocket size the same throughout all the sizes, then you don't have to grade. If you want to have bigger pocket for bigger sizes, you need to grade pocket placement. So let's say I'm not going to increase the pocket height, but I want to increase the pocket width. Then select the point, Ctrl J, on Y axis. It's your design, so I would go up half amount of what I have on the hem. So my hem is growing half of an inch, so my pocket, I want to grow quarter of an inch. Then select the tool, copy paste grading, copy the grading, click OK. I'm going to paste those punch holes. Yep, front is done. Because you grade the pocket placement, you have to grade the pocket exactly the same way. Otherwise, they are not gonna work. So I would copy from body to the pocket. So select the tool, copy paste grading, copy the grading, and paste to the pocket. Good. Let's move to the back. Select the center back neck point. Ctrl J, this time 1/8 of an inch on X axis. Okay. For the high shoulder point, 1/4 of an inch on X axis. And for Y, minus 1/8 of an inch. The bigger size going down. So the neck width is growing for the bigger sizes, right? Click OK. And select the neck curve. With smooth path grading tool, make the curve smooth. Select the shoulder point, 1/4 of an inch on X axis and minus 1/4 of an inch on Y axis. Underarm point, 0 on X axis and minus 1/2 of an inch on Y axis. Select the armhole curve with the smooth path grading tool. Make it smooth. And with copy paste grading tool, copy the underarm point, okay, and paste to the hem. Because the back pattern is folded, when you grade one side, the other side is grading automatically. Okay, we did grading front and back and the pocket. We are going to continue to grade the hood and sleeve next time. Do you know I make PDF written instructions for all my YouTube videos? If you want to have written instructions, go to my website and join my membership. Every Wednesday when my new video drops, I send PDF written instructions to your inbox. You will have a content list all of my YouTube videos, and I put the QR code for every instructions, so you can easily go back and forth between instructions and video tutorials. That's good. PatternStudio101.com/YouTube. The link will be in the description box. This channel is totally dedicated for young professionals to take their pattern making skills to the next level. Have an amazing week. See you next time.